Hey everyone, and welcome back. So today we're having a special unplanned video, but the information, at least on my end, is so important that I just had to talk about it. Now, basically we're like Wednesday night, the information actually just dropped. So I ran down to my studio to record this video, probably gonna be putting it out tomorrow, but you can already see behind me, basically the trailer playing in the loop of what we just got that is announcing that is going to be releasing, which is a new TMNT, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles beat 'em up game. And it's going to be done in a retro pixel art style. Now, for those of you who are unaware and why this information is so important, anyone growing up in the 80s or 90s, the TMNT franchise was the it franchise. It was everywhere. Every kid wanted to dress up like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle for Halloween. There was just nothing better for a kid in the 80s, growing up in the 80s and 90s. And basically, the games we got at first were subpar, but what really turned up the notch on the TMNT games were when they launched the beat-em-up franchise. Basically, starting at Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, the arcade game on the NES and other consoles, it really launched a beat-em-up style, and it really caught on. And even today, there are some of the games that fetch a huge price, especially the ones from the SNES and Genesis. The SNES one, more specifically, with Turtles in Time, is one of the most expensive games you can get on the SNES. I know there are more expensive ones, but it is definitely up there with the more expensive ones nonetheless. And basically, for years and years, we were hoping for this to happen, to keep going on that beat-em-up franchise. But, you know, story goes that licensing issues, because the original games were made by Konami, and everyone knows that Konami doesn't make too many games right now. And also at the same time, Nickelodeon now owns the TMNT franchise, and apparently, you know, they wanted to do their own thing with games, and we did get some mobile games and stuff, but they were really not what people were looking for, especially, you know, older fans of the TMNT franchise, because they were based on the more recent animated series, not the original 1980s cartoon. But what we are getting now is directly related to the 1980s cartoon, and I am super hyped. Like, basically, I was even planning a video on 80s franchises that sort of died out, that had no reason to die out, and that I were wishing to come back, and the TMNT franchise was going to be like my number one or two spot. So the fact that we're actually launching a new game, and I haven't even gotten to it yet, but I don't want this video to be too long because this is just like an information drop. We're going to go look at the website as well for the little bits of information that we have, but this game is going to be done by Dotemu. If you guys don't know, basically this is the company behind Streets of Rage 4 and Scott Pilgrim and a bunch of other retro pixel art games. So basically what I'm saying is they know what they're doing. This is not a company that we don't know can deliver on a good retro pixel art beat 'em up, because they've launched some of the best ones in the last few years. And by the way, I'm sorry I can't put the music on for the trailer, but I'm sure that stuff is copyrighted. So, you know, I just don't want to get slammed with that. But I will be leaving links down below to the trailer if you want to check it out. It has the awesome, like, revamped original theme song and everything. So you can tell that the people that are working on this game look like they loved the original 1980s franchise, and that's what we need to reinvigorate and really deliver on this game. Now, unfortunately, we don't get too much gameplay from this, but from what we can see is it does look very, very good. It seems very close, I would say, to the Scott Pilgrim style rather than the Streets of Rage style. So in my opinion, it's going to be delivering like that with a lower pixel count, maybe not cel shaded, because they are focusing on letting four players play at once. But anyway, let's get to that to close out the video for today. I'm going to cut off the trailer, but like I said, leave the link down below. Let's go take a quick look at what they have so far on their website. Perfect. So here we are on the Dotemu website, the page related to the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game release. Now, basically, you can get a little bit of background on the games they've done, and they specify that they did Streets of Rage 4 and Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. sort of letting you know that they know what they're doing in retro beat-em-ups. They give you a little bit of background on the storyline, where what it's going to be revolving around with basically, you know, storyline wise, but I'll let you read that if you want. I'll be linking the website as well in the video. What I want to look really quickly at are what we know so far of the features. Now, basically, a gnarly game design takes you back to the 80s. So they're, like they're saying, they're specifying on the 80s franchise, not the more modern versions, which is exactly what I personally want. And I think a lot of people out there want. Beautiful full color pixel art graphics. We can see that in some of the screen captures here. If we go in bigger, it looks, to me, it looks awesome. It's a awesome blend of retro and new style. Old school gameplay enhanced with super fresh mechanics. Probably, I'm guessing it's going to be something like the Scott Pilgrim versus the World. We're probably going to have an upgrade system for the different characters. Up to 4 players simultaneously. And this is the awesome part. I can't wait. I'm really hoping this game is coming to Switch. I don't see how it could not be, because this game, the whole point of going retro like this means that it'll easily run on the Switch. But I can't wait to break out 4 controllers on my Switch and play with my kids. It's going to be amazing. Play with iconic TMNT characters and vehicles in diverse gameplay options. So they're throwing out there that we're going to be controlling vehicles. And with a 1.5 minute trailer, pretty much everything in there you can think is going to be voluntary. And we saw surfing, we saw vehicles. So I'm thinking that there are going to be surfing stages, vehicle stages, which basically blends with what those old games were. If you know them back in the day, check out some YouTube videos. You can see some gameplay from Turtles in Time and whatnot, and it had all those type of things in there. A radical new story mode and totally more to come. Now, on another part of their page, they do specify that, like I said, it's launching for PC and consoles. They don't specify yet what consoles and what the timeline is. I do hope that really, really soon we're going to start getting a little bit more concrete information on this. But I just wanted to drop with you what we know so far, because I personally will be following this super closely. I'm really hoping they're also going to get a special physical edition of this game, because I will buy the biggest collector's edition possible for this game. But anyway, let me know if you guys are hyped for the TMNT beat-em-up that is coming, which is Shredder's Revenge. I didn't even say the title, I think. Yes, I'm just too into it. Sorry about this. As you can see, this is a totally unscripted, unprepared video. But nonetheless, I wanted to share it with all of you. So anyway, as usual, on the way out, let me know what you think of these videos. Do you like when I do a sort of random, when a huge bit of news like this drops? As usual, if you want to support the channel, best thing to do, hit that like button, subscribe if you aren't already, and hit the notification bell so you know when all my videos come out. But that's pretty much it for today. Let me know down below in the comments if you're as hyped as I am. But as usual, I hope I'll see all of you in my next video.